who is a student of Ustad Shujat Ali and Ustad Tari Khan. And then we have Nasir Ali over there managing our sound system for us today. So we will begin with what Salamat Ali has suggested we call the Mujra'i style of singing the Ghazal, which was made famous by the Tawais, or the singing dancing girls of the early, late 1800s and early 1900s. This is an older form with greater emphasis on monodic aspects, especially to facilitate dancing and dramatic effect. So I will now, Salamat, so you will illustrate this particular gayaki. Begin with that particular
Thank you.
which is a musical intonation to express certain kinds of emotions.
Judaism.
totally dead audience. So let's give them a lot of ba-ba's. And ba-ba means wonderful, wow. So ba-ba, and you can, you know, go with your hand, with the rhythms, and let it all out. One, two, the ghazal that he was just singing is again, you know, filled with all kinds of longings of the lover who tells the beloved that even though he has left him, he should come back once again just to leave him again. So the pain of separation and the pain of togetherness is something that is constantly, a constant theme of our ghazals, of these ghazals. One other thing that I want to tell most of you here, because you may not be aware, that in South Asia, poetry is a way of life. So that we sing it, we recite it in everyday life. In other words, if I'm angry with my friend, I will suddenly think of a particular couplet that suits the occasion, and I will recite that. Instead of saying, well, you know, I'm really upset with you, you will say that instead. And lovers will speak couplets from famous ghazals to express the way that they feel. And it'll always be in the third person. It'll be someone else's poem, but actually it's your thought. So poetry and music are so blended in South Asia that they can never be separated. How does a poem become famous? Why do we all know about these poems that he's singing? Believe me, we have not read them in books. We have heard them being sung, being recited, but mostly being sung. So music and singing is a very integral part of the culture of South Asian music and South Asia, especially ghazal singing. And, you know, nazm poems also besides ghazal, any kind of poetry. If it's not sung, in other words, it's not really testing out quite right. It's not, it hasn't withstood the test. If it's being sung and people have taken it to heart and they're humming it in the street, they're humming it to each other, then the poet has arrived. So I wanted to just let you know a few of these things because that is so much a part of what we're doing here tonight, is learning about this whole cultural aspect of South Asian poetry and music. It's always terrible to interrupt a musician when he's just about on the fourth or the fifth couplet and they've just started to get, you know, warm up. But in the situation that we are in, where it's a performance lecture, you know, I think we will do a little bit of that as well, just so. And if you have any really pressing questions, don't hesitate to ask. You can raise your hand when he finishes, and perhaps if we can, we will answer that. Okay? So this particular ghazal that he just sang, which was Ranjishi Sahi, by Faraz, a relatively modern poet, contemporary poet, who's, you know, no longer living, but nevertheless we regard him as a modern poet. This is a newer style of singing that he was illustrating, as opposed to the first ghazal that he sang, which was in a very classical style. And now we are going to do... So now we are going to explore another kind of singing, which is called the Tumri style of singing. And this doesn't apply just to the ghazal, it applies to different kinds of poetry. But ghazal has also incorporated it very nicely into its texture. So the text generally in a Tumri style ghazal is romantic. A Tumri by itself, any kind of poetry that you sing in the Tumri style, is romantic, devotional in nature. It's characterized by sensuality and greater flexibility with the rock, as it works with the rock. And often the Tumris have origins in folk literature and folk music. And now Salamat Ali Sahab will illustrate this particular kind of singing with a ghazal. And the ghazal is by Mohsin Mubali, for those of you who are familiar with his name. And how many, you sing about four or five shares?
Three.
Okay, thank you.
We have four or five kind of style of singing. Khayal, Chumri, and Ghazal, and Nurbat. If you sing Raag, then you have some conditions, some laws. And when, if you want to sing Chumri, you don't have too much conditions, like jazz. And the Chumri style, I can explain a little bit. Lisa.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
of that one where he says, gulo me rang bhare baad no bahar chale chale bhi aao ki gulshan ka karobar chale. Can anyone tell me what that means? Gulo me rang bhare, the flowers have been endowed or imbued with color. Gulo me rang bhare baad no bahar chale, the breeze of the new spring is blowing. Chale bhiyao, come my beloved. Ki gulshan ka karobar chale. So that the business of the garden can start. And the word business is so beautifully used in Urdu. It's a word, it's a very official word, karobar. But this is the poet's greatness, that he uses this in such a way that it has become extremely poetic and lyrical, and we can't think of any other word to take its place. The second one is a beautiful tribute of a lover to his beloved, in which he says that zindagi kar kya karte hain. Everybody loves in life, you know, in life, in this world, everybody falls in love, everybody loves. But my beloved, I will love you even after, even in death. And so that's the refrain. And then he continues to say beautiful things about the beloved and about his relationship and how he, what kind of a love he has for her. I mean, it's a very long ghazal, so I'm not going to translate everything. Perhaps next time we'll have an on-screen translation on that. And you'll come back again, all of you, and we'll do this again. But in the meantime, what are you going to sing now?
Kubaku Pelgi?
I know.
Yes.
So it's good we're having different kinds of poets now. This is Kubaku O Abadabi Ayane.
मेरी फरमाइश है संगीत तकनीर की गजल देख तो दिल के जहाँ से
poetess of Pakistan who died very young, very early, and the ghazal has been made famous, of course, by recitations over the years and by our famous media son-in-law, Salamat Ali, is going to sing. Parveen Shakir.
Yes, I will sing first Meetati Me.
Meetati
Me. Then I will sing Guru Gandhi Bhasha.
So he's going to start. Yes. He's going to sing the, a classical ghazal at the request of Professor Aftab, who's from Colombia, who's joining us today. And then he will sing Parveen Shakir's ghazal.
Ye raag hai jhanjhoti. The raga's name is jhanjhoti. It's very beautiful rap. Shari Mabara Zani Mabara Zari Zari Zani Mabara Zari Mabara Zari Zari Dekhto dil ke jaan se uthta Thank you.
Thank you. Shabbat Shalom. Thank you.
Such a lovely audience, and let's give another round of applause.